Hello everybody and welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today I'll be showing you how to add a transparent logo to your mesh. So let's say this cube right here, let's just create a basic material. We'll click on Use Nodes and set the color to probably an orange reddish color, something like this. Now let's say I wanted to add my business to this cube for some reason. So I'm going to press Shift Z, we can see it's just red, and I want to add it right here on the front. So the first thing that we need to do is UV unwrap this. So go into edit mode, click on U, and since this is a cube, it's really easy. All we have to do is go cube projection and that will UV unwrap. Let's open up the UV image editor and we can see what our UV map looks like. And here we go. So the next thing that I want to do is come down here and click on node editor and then add in our logo. So press N to close off that panel. The first thing that we'll be adding is an image texture. So you can press Shift A, go to texture and image texture right here. I'm going to move it over to the left. Then press Shift A. We're going to be adding in a color and then mix RGB. Place that right here. Open up your logo with this image texture. So click open and I have mine right here. I have three different images that I'll be using in this tutorial. This first image right here is my logo for Blender Made Easy. So I'm gonna click on that and click open image. Now we need to take the color and plug it into the top input, actually no, the bottom input of this mix node. Now to get that same color, since if we take this color and plug it into the diffuse shader, it gets rid of that. So what I'm going to do is click on this menu, click on the eyedropper tool and select that same color. Then take the color out of the mix node and plug it into the diffuse shader. Now, if we press Shift Z, we can see our image working, but it still looks a little bit weird. The reason for that is because we need to take the alpha channel out of our image texture and plug it into the factor. Now that we've done that, we can see our logo clearly. If we rotate the view around, we can see that our logo is on every single face of the cube. And let's say we only want it on one face. What we need to do is come down to the image texture and change this from repeat to clip. And now it's not anywhere. So we need to go back to the UV image editor, click on this drop down menu, select our image, and find this face right here. We can also see our logo is on that side. If we click on this face and we move it into the center, it'll move that logo into the middle of the face. Now to get rid of this one, we can just select that face, make sure you're in face select mode, select that face, come over to the UV image editor, press G, and just move it out of the image, and then it disappears. There we go. So now we have our transparent image on our mesh. Now another thing that we can do with the node editor is change this to add, and that will kind of blend the logo into the red material and you can kind of see it's fading out. I'm going to set this back to mix, and another way to control the transparency of the logo is to add in a color brightness contrast node and place that underneath the alpha channel right here. If we turn down the brightness, it will start to make the logo more transparent and until it fades all the way out. So this brightness contrast node will help if you want to make the logo a little bit less transparent. There we go. Okay, so now that we've learned that, let's learn how to do it if we have an image texture already on our mesh. So I'm going to go to layer 2. We have a cube right here. I'm going to click on new and that will create a new material. And then we'll add in a brick texture. So press Shift A, go to texture, image texture, take the color and plug it into the diffuse, then click open. I'm going to select that brick texture that we have in this folder, this one right here, open that up. Next, we need to UV unwrap this. So go into edit mode, press A once or twice to make sure everything is selected, U, cube projection. Now, if you go to rendered view, we can see our cube. If we look at our material, we can see that the UV map is actually stretched out, and that is because we haven't applied the scale to our mesh. So what we need to do is change this back to solid view, go into object mode, Control A or Command A on a Mac and click on scale. And that will tell Blender the scale of the mesh. Now, if we go into edit mode, click U, cube projection, Now it will fit properly. So if I press Shift to Z, we can see the bricks are now in the right position. Okay, so how to add the logo with a texture already in place is basically the same thing. So I'm going to press Shift D on this image texture, come down here and select that Blender Made Easy logo. Then press Shift A, go to Color, and then Mix RGB. Place that right here. Take the color output, plug it into the second, then take the alpha channel and plug it into the factor. And there we can see it. Now, there's another thing that we need to do because it's repeating that same image. We could come down here and click on clip and that will only display one, but it's not in the right position. And if we open up the UV image editor and move this around, it will also move the brick texture in the background, and I don't want that. So what I'm going to do is come down to the object data panel over on the right side and add in a new UV map. So click on that plus sign and we're going to name this UV map logo. Next, we need to come down here, click on node editor and apply that UV map to this image texture. So to do that, you can press Shift A, go to input and then attribute. With this, we can type in the name logo, since that is the name that we have down here. Make sure it is spelled correctly with the caps and everything. Take the vector and plug it into the vector of the image texture. Now, if we come down here, click on UV image editor, we can now edit where the logo is placed without affecting the brick texture. So if I click on this face, I can move this around and you can see it's moving the logo, but it's not moving the texture, which is perfect. Now I'm just gonna make sure that it's not repeating. Oh, looks like there's a logo over here. So I'm gonna select that face and then move it up out of the way. Same thing here, move it up. And there we go. So all we have is the logo on the front face. Now that we've done that, let's figure out how to add multiple logos to your mesh. So it's basically the same thing. All you have to do is create another UV map. I'm just gonna call this logo 2. And I'm going to move these out of the way. Right click on this mix node, shift right click on the logo, and then on the attribute node, and then press Shift D. Next, take the color output, plug it into the top, then take this and plug it into the diffuse shader. Next, let's select another image or another logo. So I'm going to click on this menu, come down to the folder, which is this one right here, select that logo and click open. There we go. Let's change this to logo 2 since it's using another UV map. Then if we go back to the UV image editor, we can now move this face wherever we want. So if we want it to go to the left, we can do that right there. And then we can see our logo is on this left side. So there you go, guys. That is how you add a logo to any mesh in Blender. And this applies to more than just logos. It can be used for grunge maps, different scratches, or different things like that. This method applies for any transparent image. So thanks everyone for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe for more Blender tutorials, and I'll see you in the next one.